I am going to design the web page, and the web page will look like this. And the web page is going to look like this with different elements. Anjali, please mute your microphone. Title of the page should be Welcome to Selenium should be the title of the page. Okay, next. I should have a username text box. Handwriting might be poor because of digital handwriting. Username text box.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, okay. Now are you able to see Paramshu? Password box. Then login button. And I have some reports box. Reports checkbox. And I will have different radio button, male radio button, female radio button, female radio button. Please mute your microphones, Anjali, Paramshiv, everyone. Don't unmute. If you have any doubts, you can unmute and a link called Google link. A hyperlink. If I click on this, it has to navigate to Google page like that. Next, I will have an image. Next, image with link. This is a normal image. If I mouse over on this, it will be as a normal cursor only. But if I mouse over on this, it will change to hand symbol. It will be an image. If I mouse over on this, it will change to a hand symbol. And if I click on this, it will navigate to some other page. It will navigate to some Flipkart page or some other page. Okay, this is image with link. Then I'll have a single select drop down. I'll have a list of cities. I can select one city at a time. I can select multiple cities at a time. This is single select drop down, and this is multi select drop down. I'll have a text area where I can write the description. I'll have a file choosing button, that is browse button. If I click on this, a window will appear to select a file. Browse buttons normally what we see in application. These are the different elements what you will find in your web page. Apart from this, do you find any other elements in the web page? Think of that. No. That is nothing but this upload button is nothing but browse button. Okay, these are the download is nothing but it's a link. To that link, they will give the functionality to download. These are the basic elements in a web page. If you know how these basic elements are built in a web page, you might see some elements like this. This is the combination of radio button and checkbox, what they make. Many other things, whatever they make, it will be a combination of some elements, some basic elements. These are the basic elements. If you know these elements, that's more than sufficient for us, because we are not developers. We are not going to develop the web page. We are going to test the web page. That's why just what is this, and know the terminologies of each and every element. What is this element called? text box. What is this box? Password box. There is a lot of There is a lot of difference between text box and password box. What is this? Button. Good. What is this? Checkbox. What is this? Radio button. Next one is image. Next one is image with link. This is just a minute, guys. I'll come. Akshara has went. This is single select drop down. Select drop down. And next one is multi select drop down. And this is text area. Text area. Normally we create text area to write descriptions. Okay, this is file choosing button. Choosing button. This is file choosing button. Okay, this is a web page what I am going to build now. Before that, take on the requirement, this requirement page. Next we are going to build the web page. How to build, we will see. Slowly, take down this.
the elements' names also.
Okay, now let's start building this web page. Normally, any web page is built with HTML. Any web page is built with HTML. We can write the HTML code anywhere in the Notepad, Edit Plus, Notepad Plus Plus, normal Notepad. Anywhere we can write the code. But while you are saving the file, you want to save with .html extension. You want to save with .html extension. I am going to write this in the Notepad itself. Let me write this in the Notepad itself. I am going to just my intention is to design this web page now. I am just going to design this web page. Whatever I have written here in the blackboard, I am going to design this same web page as it is. Let me open the Notepad and start designing the web page. This any HTML page. We'll start with HTML tag. Any HTML, don't take down the code, I will give you time to take down. And it will end with HTML tag. HTML page will start with HTML tag and end with HTML tag. HTML tag has two child tags called head tag and head tag closes separately like this and body tag. And body tag closes separately like this. Body tag, head tag and body tag. Are you getting this? This is the basic structure of HTML page. Okay, after creating this web page, control S, save. Save, control S or go to save. Save. I'm going to F. Your classes, all your files will be under this particular folder only. Batch 114. Yeah. It started recording. No need to worry about that. Already done. Oh, batch 113. Batch 114. Okay. Here, name it as sample.html. I have saved this file. Once you have created the file, go here. Go to under classes. Under batch 114. Now I have created this file, sample.html. If you create with .html, of course it will create a file like this. Once either you can double click or right click, open with Chrome browser. Whichever the browser you want, you can open with that. It will open with the browser. Output will be here. I have not written anything. I have just created the structure of HTML page. That's why it is showing me the blank page here. And this is the structure of HTML page. Okay. This is the basic structure of HTML. Take down this basic structure of HTML. Just take down the basic structure of HTML. This is the basic structure of HTML. It starts with HTML tag and ends with HTML tag. It has two child tags, head tag and body tag. Head tag has four different child tags called title tag, meta tag, CSS tag, and JS tag. These are not for us. These are not necessary for us at all. Okay, this meta tag is used to add keywords. This CSS is used for cascading style sheets to style the, to change the font sizes or something. This JS is for JavaScript, which means that if I have a text box, if the text box has to take a minimum of 4 characters, maximum of 32 characters, if you want to do some validations, those things will be done in JS. These things are not necessary for us, first of all. Forget about this. Now, title. Title is necessary. Title tag. Title will be all the other elements, whatever you are going to build, input text, text box, radio buttons, all those things should be inside this body tag only. Title tag. What is the title of your page? Welcome to Selenium. Should be the title of my page. This title tag closes separately. If the tag is open, it should be closed somewhere. Okay. Now, Control S, save. Now, again, I have to go and open this. This I have changed a little bit. Double click on this open. Or else what you can do, already I have opened this, right? Just refresh this, then you will see the output here. If I refresh this, it has changed to Welcome to Selenium. Okay, what I am going to do from now onwards, I am going to change the code here, save this, and come and refresh here, so that it will get the updated code. I don't want to go and open the file each and every time. Are you getting this? Now, let us start building the web pages. Let us start building the web pages now. What is the first element in our web page? Element name. What? Text box. Username text box is the first element what I am going to build. Okay. Input is the tag name. Input is the tag name to create the text box. Input is the tag name. Input tag closes separately. It won't close separately. It's a self-closing tag. It closes there itself. Input is the tag to create the text box. It has created a text box here. Have you understood? Input is the tag name to create the text box. If you want to create the radio button, input type equal to radio. It will create a radio button. See, it creates a radio button here. If you want to create a checkbox, input type equal to checkbox. If you want to create a text box, normally you should have given type equal to text. But if you give type equal to text, it will create a text box here. But if you are not giving anything called type equal to text, right? If you are not giving anything called type equal to text, it will create a text box itself. Because by default, the type value is text. By default, the type value is text. That's why if you are not giving anything, then it will take type equal to text. So that it creates a text box. We need a text box here. Either you can give type equal to text or else just you can give input also, so that it creates a text box. Are you understanding how to create a text box now? No. Then created. I need a label for this text box, right? As per my requirements, I need the username as a label for this text box. How to create that just give that label here. Username colon. That's it. It will create a text box. Go and refresh here. Refresh. You have got a username text box. You can type something. Any doubts how to create the text box? Now, imagine that my web page has many other elements also, like first name, last name, like this. I have many elements. Now if I refresh, I'll get all these elements here, right? I'm getting all these elements. Now, can you tell me whether this particular code corresponds to first name or last name? It corresponds to first name. For example, if I have 50 elements like this, in between if I want to identify a particular element's code, whether that belongs to the previous element or next element, is it easy? It's quite a difficult. If you have too much code, if I want to verify whether that particular code corresponds to first name or last name, then it will be quite a difficult for me. So that what we will do normally is, whenever we create some elements, we will give a ID or name for that element. ID equal to uname or something, username. So that we will come to know that this particular code corresponds to username text box. If you have too many elements, to avoid the confusion, either we can give ID or name. Either we can give ID or name, so that we can, it will be easy for the further reference. Are you getting this? This is how I can create an element. Done. Created the username text box. One element is done. Next. What is the next element? Password box. Just a minute. Let me copy paste this code itself, whatever I have. Password. Input type. Let me give PWD. Done, right? Let me refresh this. Is this correct? No, why? Password. If I give the password icicibank.com like this, right? Then no one will use that icicibank.com at all. Right? Password box is different from text box. Input type equal to password, so that it will create a password box. Password box is different from text box. Password box takes an, text box takes a normal characters, whereas password box takes an encrypted characters. Okay? Just a minute, I'll come back. Okay, next element. What is the next element what we are going to build? What is the element name? Button. I am going to build this button now. I am going to build this button. What is the tag to create button? Input. Type equal to button. If I give input type equal to button, it will create a button here. Let me see the output. Refresh this so that I have got the button. Okay, either you can give input type equal to button, or else you can give input type equal to submit also. So if you give input type equal to submit, you will get a button name itself as submit. So that I don't want to the button name as submit. What I need, the button name, button name as login, so that I am creating an empty button here. If I give a name here, it will come before the button. If I give something here, it will come after the button. But I want on the button as a login. I want the on the button as login. So that what I can give, value equal to login. I've got the button name as value equal to login. Got it? For this button also, it is always preferred to give some unique IDs. Unique IDs for each and every element. Login button or something like this. This is preferred always to give some either IDs or name for each and every element. Right? Next. What is the next element? Checkbox. How to create the checkbox? You know already. Tell me. Input type equal to checkbox. Checkbox. Input type equal to checkbox. It is preferred to give ID or name. You can give either ID or name. Anything can be given. Now I have created a checkbox. But I need something called reports here, right? Well, where I can give? Give after this. Reports. That is what I have created. Done. Reports. Now, what is the next element? In your requirement page, what is the next element? Radio button. I need to create the radio button. Let me create that radio button. What is the tag to create radio button? Input type is equal to radio, only radio, input type equal to radio. Refresh this. You have got a radio button. But do you want the radio button there? No, it should be in the next line. What I can do in that case? Give BR tags, breaking reference. It will give a breaking reference and bring it here. But normally, in real time, they won't use BR tags. What they do is, they create tables and place the elements inside the table so that when they create a table, automatically it will fall in a new line. Let me explain you more clearly about this. They'll create a table. They'll create a table like this. They'll create a table with one row and two columns. They'll create a table like this. They'll put the male radio button here and female radio button here. When they create a new table, automatically it will fall in a new line. This table is created with one row and two columns in that one row. And they will divide all the elements into different tables. They'll put all the links in one table, all the images in one table, all the images in one all the images in one table, all the select dropdowns in one table. All the select dropdowns in one table. All the other elements in one table. Like this, they will divide the page into different tables normally. As soon as they get the requirement, based upon their convenience, they will divide the page into different tables. And they will put the elements inside the tables. Okay. This male and female radio button is in one table with one row and two columns. This Google link is in one table with how many rows? One row and one column inside that row. This image and image with link is in one table with how many rows? Two rows and one column in each row. Right? Then, this single select dropdown and multi select dropdown is in one table with how many rows? One row. First row should be there. Then inside the row, column should be there. Okay? Inside one row with two columns. One row with two columns. This text area and browse button is in one row with two columns. Okay, that is how this web page will be divided. If you want to create a table, let me create an empty table like this. Okay. Table will be created with table tag. Table tag ends like this. This table has how many rows? One row. This table has one row, TR. This TR will close separately. Has how many columns? Two columns. Columns is nothing but TD. Table data, TD. Here I will have mail radio button. I can create mail radio button. Next, one more TD. In this I should have female radio button. Like this I can create. So that it will create inside the table. This is the structure of the table. Just take down only this table structure. Don't take down any other thing. This is the basic structure of table.
Okay.
Now, let me create the table. Let me create an empty table first. You can take them from here also as well. Table. Table. Table should be closed separately like this. Table. This table should have how many rows? One row. Table row closes here. This table should have two columns. TD. 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 Here I should have mail radio button. Here I should have male radio button. Here I should have female radio button. That is how I have to build the web page now, right? How to create the radio button? Input type equal to radio. Input type equal to radio. Radio button. See, this is inside the table, but I am unable to see the table, right? Why? Because I didn't give border for the table. If you give border equal to 1, you can see the border of the table. Now you are able to see table with one row and two column. In the first row, first column, you have one radio button. First row, second column, it is empty. Okay, this is how normally by default the border value will be 0. The border value will be 0. That's why it will not be able to, you will not be able, at the background it will be there, but you will be unable to see that. If you give border, you will be able to see that. Right? Next. Input type equal to radio. You need a label for that, right? Mail. Then give that radio button. Mail. I have got it. In the same way, create a female radio button also. Female radio. Input type equal to radio. Female. It is better to give IDs always, I said, right? ID equal to male or something. Here in the same way, ID equal to female. Give unique IDs always. Now refresh this. You are getting male and female radio button in a table. What developers do is, when they are creating, they will keep the border for the table. As soon as they complete the entire design, right, they will search for this border equal to 1 and remove all the borders. And remove all the borders. So that when you are able to see the background of that, there will be a table. Background of that, there will be a table. If you want to see that, I can show you some examples also. Let me go to this web page called demo.actitime.com. It is a small web page. When you see the source code of this web page, you can see how it is designed inside the tables. Yes, it's loading. Right click on this element. Inspect so that you will get the source code of this element. See, this is an input tag TDTR TBody. Slowly, if you go up, it is in the table. This element is in the table. If you go up little bit, that table is inside another table. This table is inside another table. Another table like that. They have divided the entire page in big table. Inside that there is a table. Inside that there is a table. That is how normally in real time the web pages are built. That is why I have created tables and put the elements inside the table so that you will understand more better. They won't use any BR tags and all. Have you understood up to here? Any doubts with this? Okay. Next. What is the next element what we are going to build? Google link. That should be with one table with one row and one column. First design an empty table. Later on I can put the element inside the table. Okay. Let me design an empty table. How to create a table? Table should be created. Is the table, is it correct? Whatever I have created. Table with one row and one column inside that, so that I am going to create a link here. I am going to create a Google link. To create a link, I will be using a tag called A tag. A tag is used to create the link. Anchor. Anchor. The full form. What does the anchor in the ship does? It links to some other thing, which means that it links to water and it stops the ship. Right? In the same way, here A, you are creating a link and you are connecting to some other web page. Okay? A, anchor. href is equal to. Where, if you click on that link, where you have to navigate? You have to navigate to http://www.google.com. You want to navigate to that. And A tag closes separately like this. A tag is not a self-closing tag. This input tag is a self-closing tag. A tag is not a self-closing tag. Whatever the text you give here, that it will be displayed here. Okay. Now if you click on this, it will navigate to Google page. It will navigate to Google page. Done. But you don't want the text as some random text here. You want the text also as Google. Give the text here in the web page. Instead of this text, I am going to give it as Google. Done. Now refresh this. You will get a link called Google. If you click on this, it will navigate to Google page. Understood? Next. What is the next element? Image and image with link should be in one table with how many rows? Two rows and one column in each row. All right? Let me design that. Let me design that. This is the table what I am going to create. Table with how many rows? Two rows and one column in each row. Is it correct? Whatever I have created here? Table with two rows. In first row I have one column. In second row I have another column. Here I am going to create a normal image. Here I am going to create a image with link. Got it? Next. To create an image, I need to have an image, right? Download an image and keep an image ready with you. Okay? I am going to download an image, home.jpg or some image. Go to images. Why this is very slow? Okay, let me download this image. Download this image. Save images. Let me download to the same folder wherever I have my .html batch one. Under here, I am going to save this as home.jpg. I have saved the file under this home.jpg. I have this home.jpg, right? Now I need to display this image, home.jpg image, inside here in my web page. img is the tag to display the image. src equal to what is the file name? home.jpg. home.jpg. I have image. It's a self-closing tag. If you want id, you can give id, or else just leave it also. Okay, now it has displayed the image here. See, I have given img src equal to home.jpg. Since my this .html file and image is in the same folder, both are in the same folder, that's why directly I have given the file name here. If this home.jpg is inside my C drive under images folder, under images, if I have this home.jpg, then what I have to give here? Then I have given the complete path. C:\images/home.jpg. Since both are in the same folder, I am just giving that file name. It is preferred to keep in the same folder always. Okay, next. That is all about image. Are you understanding this image? How to display the image? Next one, what is the next one? Image with link. Okay. Now I am just going to create a link again. Again, I have created a link so that it has created a link here. I don't want the text as Google. I don't want the text as Google. Instead of this Google text, I need image there. instead of this Google text. I don't want this text as Google. I need an image. In HTML language, this is the image, right? Copy this and paste it instead of this, so that an image will be displayed. And if I click on that image, now an image will be displayed. Now this is a normal image. This is actually a link only, but link with not a text, with an image. But if I click on this, it will go to Google page. It is going to Google page. If you don't want to go to Google page, if you want to go to Flipkart page, then change this to Flipkart. Change this to Flipkart. It will go to Flipkart page. Refresh this. If I click on this, it is navigating to Flipkart page. Okay. If you don't want to have the home.jpg, if you want mobile.jpg, download mobile.jpg and give mobile.jpg as a name here, so that it will display the mobile image there. And if you click on that, it will navigate to Flipkart page. Are you clear until here? How to different element has different tag names and attribute names. You don't want to remember anything here. Now what you want to come to know here is, you want to come to know what is the parent tag. This A tag is the child tag of this TD tag. This TD tag is the child tag of this TR tag. This TR tag is the child tag of this table tag. This table tag is the child tag of this body tag. Body tag. This body tag is the child tag of this HTML tag. HTML tag is the parent. This parent-child relationship, you need to understand this. That's the only thing what you have to understand. You don't want to by heart any code here, because already developers have written the code and given to you. Okay? This is only four more elements are left. What are those? Single select dropdown, multi select dropdown, text area and browse button. Let me create single select dropdown and multi select dropdown now. This should be in one table with one row and two columns, right? Let me design the empty table. Is the table is correct what I am developing? Table with one row and two columns. Yes or no? Yes. Here I need single select dropdown. I need single select dropdown. Select is the tag to create the select dropdown. Select tag is not a self-closing tag. Select. That's it. It will create a select dropdown. Sorry. It will create a select dropdown. It has created a select dropdown here. Are you able to see that? Select dropdown. Now, what I need? Give some ID. Normally, I will be giving ID for any element, right? CT. That's it. You have created a select dropdown. But for that select dropdown, you need some options, right? Like Bangalore, Chennai, Delhi, Kolkata, like that. Give that in the option tag. Option value equal to 1. I am going to give Bangalore as first option. Option Bangalore. I've got an option called Bangalore, right? Like that, if you want different options, what you can do? Copy this. 1, 2, Chennai, 3 is Mumbai, 4 is Pune. Now, if you refresh this, you have got all the four options. This is how to create a single select dropdown. Next, I am going to create a multi-select dropdown. What I am going to do, let me copy paste this. Let me change this ID value to cities. Now I have created single select dropdown only. I didn't create multi-select dropdown. Now I need to convert this to a multi-select dropdown. If you want to make that to a multi-select dropdown, then you need to pass one more attribute called multiple equal to true. It will create It will make that to a multi-select dropdown. Have you got it? By pressing Control, you can select multiple cities here. That is all about multi-select dropdown. Two more elements are left. What are those? Text area and file choosing button. Both should be in one table with one row and two columns. One row and two columns. Here you have, is the table is correct, whatever I have created? Table with one row and two columns. Here I need a text area. Text area to ID equal to description or something. Area. Got it? Now refresh this, you will get a text area. You have got a text area, right? That's it. This is all about how to create text area. What is the next element? File choosing button. Input type equal to, input type equal to file. This is a file choosing button. If you want ID equal to browse or something, you can give file choosing button. Now refresh this, you have got a file choosing button. Okay, this is how to create a file choosing. Hardly we have taken 45 minutes to develop this web page. That's it, right? One web page, hardly to, but to make colors and all those things, it might take more time. Just to design the basics of HTML, we hardly took only 45 minutes to 1 hour max. Okay, so that if you know the basics of HTML, identifying the elements become very easy. To do any automation, we are going to identify the elements and perform action on that element. To identify the elements, we should know the basics of HTML. That is why it is not our job at all. Developers is going to develop the web page and give to us. From next class, which means that from Monday's class onwards, we are going to identify the elements by using different element locators. We are going to identify the elements. Okay, but to step into that, we have to learn the basics of HTML. But normally in real time, those who are working also in Selenium, they will not be aware with this with this 1 hour of stuff. That's why they will be feeling lot of difficulty to identify the elements. Okay. Just a minute, I'll come back. Now what I am going to do here is, there is a huge code here, right? It is too difficult to remember the entire code. Right, I am going to give a simple shortcut how to remember everything. Okay, so that you can remember everything. For any big topic, whatever you are going to learn in future, I will give you some shortcuts. If you learn those shortcuts, it will be very easy for you. Let me tell. I will give you ample time to take down. You will get sufficient time to take down the notes, don't worry. Element. Next, tag name. Mandatory attribute value, additional attribute value. What is the first element? Text box. What is the tag name to create the text box? Input is the tag name. What is the mandatory attribute? Type equal to text. You have to give type equal to text. That is the attribute. And additional attribute, either you can give ID or name. That is user defined value. You can give anything. User defined value. What is the next element? Password box. What is the tag name? Input is the, what is the mandatory attribute? Type equal to password. Here you can give either ID or name, that is user defined. Are you understanding why I am giving shortcuts like this for each and every? Now you don't want to write the entire code also. If you have this, that's more than sufficient. You can start building, because you have already taken the basics of HTML, basic structure of HTML. Inside body, if you write all these tags, then of course you can build your web page. Okay, what is the next element? Button. What is the tag to create button? Input. Type equal to button or submit also I can give. Anything I can give to create a button. Here I will be giving value, that is button name as an additional attribute. Next one. Checkbox. Input is the tag to create the checkbox. Type equal to checkbox. Here you will be giving either ID or name, that is user defined. Got it? Next. Radio button. Radio button. What is the tag to create the radio button? Input type equal to radio ID. One more thing I forgot to tell you here. I'm coming to recap this. I forgot to tell you this. Now, after this, can this happen? Can I select both male and female radio button? I have to select only one, right? If I do like this, no one will use this application. It's a bug actually. So that what I can give here is, give a common name. Name equal to gender. Give a common name. Name equal to gender. So that I refresh this. Now you can go and select only one out of that. You cannot select both. If you have five cities, out of five cities, if you want to select only one radio button, then give a common name to that five cities, so that out of those five cities, only one will get selected. That is how, that is called grouping the elements. Out of that group, only one will get selected. Okay. Now here, in that case, I have to give both ID and name. One for uniqueness and one for grouping. Name should be used for grouping. Only name can be used for grouping. IDs cannot be used for grouping. Okay. User defined. Next element. What is that? Link. That is link. What is the tag name to create the link? A. href. What is the mandatory attribute? Href. You will be passing URL. Then if you want ID or name, you can give, or else just leave it also. ID or is additional attribute. Next one. Image. What is the tag to create image? IMG is the tag to create image. What is the mandatory attribute? SRC equal to file name. Here you will be giving either ID or name, that is user defined. Next one is image with link. That is nothing but combination of these two, is image with link. Next one, single select drop down. What is the tag to create single select drop down? Select, no mandatory attribute. Either you can give ID or name, that is user defined. That is all about single select drop down. Next one, multi select select drop down. Then for that also select drop down. Here what you will be giving the mandatory attribute? Multiple equal to true, so that it becomes a multi select drop down. Here you can give both either ID or name, that is user defined. Next element. Text area. Text area. What is the tag to create text area? Text area is the tag to create the text area. No mandatory attribute. Either you can give ID or name, that is user defined. What is the next one? File choosing button. File choosing upload button or file choosing button. What is the tag to create that? Input type equal to button. File. Input type equal to file, so that it will create file choosing button. ID or name, that is user defined. That's it. Done. All the whatever I have written for last 1 hour of code, I have made it into one tabular column now. If you have this, it is very easy for you, right? Now it's just like a shortcuts what I am giving. Okay, first take down this, later on you can take down the code as well. You have another 20 minutes to take down. You can take down this. Did Ramanji give table like this? No. Who's this? Paramshu. Taking the screenshots. Take down into your notes. Don't take down the screenshots. If you take down, you will understand a lot of things here. That is why I am telling you to take down. I am going for... Next class is on Monday. No class tomorrow and day after tomorrow. I am taking a leave. As I said, four leaves for your batch. One is Thursday, Friday and February 6th. That comes on Wednesday and February 18th. These are the only leaves what I will take. Apart from that, there is no leaves. On this and you can take down just two minutes and you can take down this as well, and once you are done with this, take down this and you can take down this as well, and finally take down this. And this.